Climate change and renewable energy are high on the international agenda. The Middle East, the core of the planet's sunbelt, is already engaging with this energy transformation, diversifying into solar. Helping meet this demand is Qatar Solar Technologies. Its chairman and CEO, Dr. Khalid Hajri, joins me now. Dr. Hajri, what is the future of the solar energy industry?
There is a projection by 2040 that 60% of the energy will be represented by renewable, 26%. Of that will be from solar. The price of the solar industry is coming down. In fact, the price today, if you compare it with the megawatt produced by gas, showing $122 per megawatt using solar and $118 per gas. You can see the gap is coming down. Last year, 2015, first time when the investment in the renewable and the solar is going up, while we in the oil and gas is coming down. So that's why solar will help overcoming some of this climate change. Qatar Solar Technology will be laying the foundation for the solar industry development across the MENA region.
You've made significant investments in the photovoltaic businesses, Centrotherm and Solar World. How does that position QS Tech across the photovoltaic value chain?
One of our vision is to be a globally leading integrated company. Getting involved in Solar World, which is the major producer of panels in Europe, as well as in the USA, and also Centrotherm, which is a German company, technology provider, 95% of the polysilicon market share worldwide, and the semiconductor, they have 45% in the market. So we're three of us working together in research and development and benefiting from each of us experience, know-how, and knowledge. That also will be reinforced by the use of Qatar Science Technology Park and Qatar Foundation. And we think this will bring about a lot of improvement in the solar industry across the globe, and mainly we'll start with the MENA.
You've been building your own polysilicon production plant, the first of its kind in the Middle East. Tell me about that.
We have 1.2 million square meter. One of our vision is to be a globally integrated leading organization in the solar industry. And that land will accumulate around about 6.5 gigawatt facilities from polysilicon up to the panel production. We're doing it in a very strategic approach. We are building polysilicon plant, and that by the end of this year will be producing 8,000 ton. That will give you around about 1.3 gigawatt. And what we're doing there, we are laying the foundation for the solar industry development in the MENA region.
So that puts you in a really good position, especially with the recent Paris agreements actually coming into force to drive forward the solar industry.
Absolutely, because this is the first time after the COP21 in Paris that the government has the real commitment. And now, whether they resist the future or go along with it, there is no other option. And we will be playing a major part and promoting the government to achieve their goal as said by them.
So what are the key challenges that are facing solar players?
In the solar industry, there are two challenges we have to overcome. One, to bring the price down. Two, the storage. And that will come through the research and development. And by dealing with Solar World and Qatar and Centrotherm and Qatar Solar Technology through Qatar Science Technology Park and Qatar Foundation, that really will make the platform for a positive contribution amongst this consortium for overcoming these challenges. And that challenge is not only for the consortium, we'll make it available for the rest of the solar industry key players. Actually, there is another third challenge, and that's the fragmentation of the industry. Solar industry so far is very fragmented, and we need to work on this to make it one group and exchanging information between all the producers and key players in this in the solar industry to make it more competitive against other source of energies.
Finally then, what does the future hold for QS Tech?
The future, we would like to be a globally integrated company worldwide. We have already started with our consortium with Solar World and Centrotherm. Two, we would like to work together for making research and development and working simultaneously while we are building our plan and our name globally. And thirdly, we will support the government for achieving their goal as they set by them based on the COP21.
Dr. Hajri, thank you very much.
Appreciate it so much. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. You can find out more about Qatar Solar Technologies at worldfinance.com. And please subscribe for more stories from the GCC region, as well as all the latest insights from World Finance.